Good evening. I'm Andrea Wolfleff, Director of Operations at the Nantucket Community Music Center. Tonight we are presenting the NCMC Salon Series Concert. We're coming to you live from St. Paul's Episcopal Church. Tonight's performance is a musical potpourri for a summer's eve. It's such a special occasion for us when our faculty get to perform together, and tonight we have three such faculty. We have Mollie Glaser on cello, Joe Hammer on organ, and Isaiah Williams on piano and organ. I'd like to thank St. Paul's Episcopal Church for allowing us to use the space this evening, and this concert is made possible by a very generous grant from the Remain Nantucket Fund, so many thanks to them as well. I would also like to let you know that registration is open for our fall session, which starts September 14th. If you are interested in any classes, we're teaching in-person and online lessons this year, so please check out our website at nantucketcommunitymusiccenter.org for more information on that. Up first this evening is Joe Hammer.
Thank you, Andrea. The first piece on the program this evening is Bach. It's a fantasia in G major. It's really interesting. It begins with a very light, airy section, followed by a five-part choral, almost, middle section that rambles. He takes it and he rambles it all over the place. You think it's going to go to one place, and all of a sudden it's off to another. And then it closes again with a very light, airy, effervescent section that closes the piece. So here we have Johann Sebastian Bach's Fantasia in G major.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm now going to turn the program over to Mollie Glaser. Mahler, are you next or?
Mahler.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Mollie and Isaiah are going to come up. I'm so sorry. We're going to do a Mahler piece, actually. A transcription. Indeed. Here we go. So, transcriptions have been a tool, a mechanism for composers forever. The instance of transcription is when a composition that was written for one instrument or an orchestra or a string quartet is transcribed for another instrument or another configuration of instruments. In this particular instance, this is a movement from Mahler, Gustav Mahler's Fifth Symphony. It's the Adagietto section that was originally composed for strings, cello, and harp. And Mark Gotham, a contemporary composer, has taken that and transcribed it for piano, cello, and organ. So here we have Gustav Mahler's Adagietto from Symphony No. 5.
Thank you. Johann Sebastian Bach wrote 6 suites for solo cello, and I'm going to play 2 movements from the first suite, which is also in G major. Our other Bach that Joe began with was in G major, so it's a theme. I'm going to start with the Allemande and end with the G.
Thank you. second posthumous etude, which isn't actually posthumous, but people tend to know it that way. It's an etude, which means it's a study, so it helps you practice two against three, meaning you play three notes in this hand in the same time it takes you to play two in this hand, which is harder than it sounds. And it helps you practice the concept of when you're playing all kinds of notes with all kinds of fingers, that this weakest finger on the top has to be the loudest and the heaviest. And I hope you enjoy.
Joe was speaking earlier about transcriptions. So we're going to play our own arrangement, transcription if you like, of three movements from the Requiem of Fauré. In general, I'm playing the vocal part. This is a beautiful choral work, originally for with organ or
originally
with orchestra?
Originally with organ and orchestra.
Organ and orchestra, so we're doing it organ as the orchestra and cello as the vocal soloist.
The first movement is Pia Jesu.
The first, why don't you tell them now?
You're over there. The first movement is Pia Jesu. The second that we're going to do is Agnus Dei, and the third is the final movement of the Requiem called In Paradisum.
I'll just hear your A.
Thank you.
So to close out the evening, we're gonna kind of wrap it in a little bow, I guess you could say, because this is also another Fantasia. This one was written about 170 years after the one that Bach composed that I played at the beginning of the program. This one is by a French composer, Alexandre Guilmont. He was a teacher, a composer, a church organist, and a concert organist. And interestingly enough, late 19th century, early 20th century, he actually played an extensive series of concerts, organ recitals, at the St. Louis World's Fair on, at the time, was the largest instrument organ in the world. And that instrument actually became the nucleus of the Wanamaker department store organ, Macy's now in Philadelphia. So if you've been to the Wanamaker or the Macy's store there in Philadelphia and heard that organ, you have actually heard an instrument that Guilmont played on himself. So, this is a very short, again, fun kind of thing. It's very Fantasia-esque, and I hope you enjoy. Potpourri. We hope you very much enjoyed it, and we look forward to having you come back again for another Nantucket Community Music Center Salon Series concert. Thank you.